Hey everybody, welcome back. This video is about transformers, an important component of X-ray imaging systems. Transformers have a very simple job. Transformers change or transform the voltage in an electrical circuit, and the voltage can be either increased or decreased. There's actually two types of transformers. A step-up transformer increases the voltage, and a step-down transformer decreases the voltage. That's not too complicated, but there is another variable affected when the voltage is transformed. When a step-up transformer increases the voltage, the amperage of the circuit decreases. And when a step-down transformer decreases the voltage, the amperage is increased. It's kind of like this. The nozzle on a water hose can be adjusted to change the pressure and flow rate of the water. When the nozzle is adjusted to a high pressure, the water comes out very fast, but there is less total water coming out. This is like a step-up transformer. There's high pressure, that's like high voltage, but a low flow rate, that's like a decrease in the amperage. When the water nozzle is adjusted to a lower pressure, the water comes out very slowly, but there's actually more total water coming out of the hose. This is like a step-down transformer. There's lower pressure, that's like lower voltage, but there's a significant increase in the flow rate. That's like an increase in the amperage. Different parts of the X-ray circuit actually need different volts and amps. The X-ray tube itself needs very high voltage to make X-rays. So that part of the X-ray circuit actually uses a step-up transformer to increase the voltage. The filament circuit itself needs a very high amperage, not a high voltage. So that part of the X-ray circuit uses a step-down transformer. A step-down transformer decreases the voltage, but significantly increases the amperage of the circuit. A transformer is made of three distinct parts. There is a core, a primary coil where the electricity comes into the transformer, and a secondary coil where the electricity comes out of the transformer. Notice that the transformer has no moving parts. The change in voltage occurs because of a process that we call electromagnetic induction. Electricity flowing through the coil on the primary side creates a fluctuating magnetic field. That fluctuating magnetic field interacts with the coils on the secondary side and induces an electrical current to flow. The number of turns on the primary and secondary side determine whether the voltage is stepped up or stepped down. In this example, the primary side has 10 turns and the secondary side has 5 turns. There are half as many turns on the secondary side, so the voltage will decrease by half. This is a step-down transformer because the voltage is decreased. If we reverse the turns ratio, the opposite is going to happen. On this transformer, the primary side has only 5 turns, and the secondary side has 10 turns. There's twice as many turns on the secondary side, so the voltage will increase by double. This is a step-up transformer because the voltage increases. Sometimes the turns ratio can be a lot more complicated, so we need a formula to use. And here's one way of writing that formula. And that's the topic of our next lesson.